Item number, SCP-405. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. Infected subjects are to be contained at SCP-405 isolation zones. These zones exist in depopulated areas. All field teams encountering SCP-405 are to be informed of the locations of nearby isolation zones. All observation of SCP-405 victims is to be done via video link from a distance of no less than 1 kilometer. If a subject suffering from SCP-405 is in the late stages upon apprehension, they are to be terminated, and all individuals within 200 meters are to undergo treatment protocol 405 Alpha if an isolation area cannot be reached in time. Treatment protocol 405 Alpha is also to be used on any individuals found in the preliminary stages of SCP-405 infection. SCP-405-1 are housed at Research Facility Location Expunged. On no account are individuals suffering from SCP-405 to be brought into contact with SCP-405-1. SCP-405-1 are to receive limited human contact from doctors and only while said doctors have been dosed with Type 3 sedatives. SCP-405-1 are housed in adjoining 10 meter by 10 meter by 10 meter cells and are not considered an escape risk. Said research facility's remote location is for their benefit, not ours. Description: SCP-405 is a contagious phenomenon of unknown origin that causes the uncontrolled development of telepathic capabilities in humans. The typical progression of the disease is as follows. Primary stage: 0 to 2 days after exposure, no noticeable effect. Initial stage: 2 to 7 days after exposure, subject begins to hear higher order thoughts of nearby subjects, seemingly at random. Thoughts about the subject are most common. Subjects rarely realize that the heard vocalizations are not spoken. Secondary stage: 7 to 10 days after exposure, subject now hears all conscious thoughts of nearby individuals. Subject will become aware of their telepathic nature. In some subjects, thought projection is first observed here. Subject will usually complain of earache and express a desire for silence. Sleep patterns typically become disrupted due to perceived noise levels. Escalation stage: 10 to 14 days after exposure. Over this period, the range of the subject's abilities increases, typically to about 200 meters, but occasionally far further. In a few rare cases where the subject has pre-existing telepathic capacity, as measured on the Mechevik-Lunton scale, range has been shown to grow exponentially out to several kilometers, leading to the early onset of terminal stage. Subject hears all conscious thoughts of humans within this range, as loudly as if the individuals were speaking directly in the subject's ear. The first suicide attempts typically occur at this point, as a result of sleep deprivation and perceived noise levels. Subjects also begin to uncontrollably project their thoughts to nearby individuals. MRI scans taken at this stage indicate several significant deformities in the audio cortex. Plateau stage: 14 to 28 days after exposure. No noticeable change in symptoms is evident at first, although many subjects begin to detect unconscious thoughts towards the end of this phase, including automatic responses and reflex actions. Subjects typically exhibit a wide range of dementias, such as consistent with sensory overstimulation and sleep deprivation by this stage, and most attempt suicide, often frequently, and with increasing levels of creativity and desperation. Restrained subjects will typically beg for termination or other extreme measures. One agent at this stage requested being used to examine SCP, normally reserved for D-class personnel. To date, all subjects have been observed to attempt to deafen themselves if able, most commonly by inserting a long, thin object, such as a pen, into their ears, until the internal structure is destroyed. Towards the end of this phase, subjects often experience catatonic episodes and begin to suffer from seizures. These are apparently not related to the telepathic abilities, but rather due to swelling in the subject's neural tissues. Terminal stage: 28 days after exposure until death. typically 32 days after exposure. Subjects slip into a coma and begin to suffer from persistent seizures caused by significant brain deformities. MRI scans taken at this stage confirm audio cortex is still processing vast quantities of data. Experiments with animals, including higher primates, confirm that SCP-405 is species-specific. The vector for SCP-405 is the subject's final mental vocalization, identified by most observers as a death scream. This vocalization occurs at the moment of death, regardless of cause, and has a range of at least 200 meters, although the more advanced the disease, the greater the range. Individuals who hear this telepathic signal are infected with SCP-405. Outbreaks of SCP-405 appear spontaneously. The ultimate cause of these outbreaks is unknown. The earliest believed SCP-405 outbreak was in the town of a famous ghost town. The entire population was recorded to have died either by their own hands or at the hands of deranged residents. Written records are consistent with the symptoms of SCP-405. The cause of SCP-405 outbreaks is unknown, although 79% have been traced to some form of educational facility. Only two cases have occurred outside the continental United States. Sufferers in the primary to early escalation stages of SCP-405 have been successfully treated with treatment protocol 405-alpha. Subjects are administered twice the standard dose of Class D amnestics and placed in a chemically induced coma for 3 days. This appears to reset brain activity to a pre-infection state and allow abnormal development to subside. Success rate is 1%, with greater success in the early stages. No treatment for the later stages exists. For an examination of disease behavior, please see the infected subject interview log. The use of Type 3 disaster synthesis quarantine measures are preemptively approved to contain large-scale SCP-405 outbreaks. To date, only individuals have recovered from SCP-405 naturally. They gained sufficient control of their abilities to deal with small groups of individuals, but are still incapable of dealing with more than individuals at a time without exhibiting extreme stress. Seizures and other neurological conditions caused by structural brain deformities are common. Such individuals are referred to as SCP-405-1A and SCP-405-1. They have adopted the designations for themselves and no longer respond to their original identities, perhaps due to the fact that all staff think of them by those designations. The potential value of SCP-405-1 to the Foundation is unclear at this time. Addendum 405-1. Storing SCP-405-1 in the same area was a bad idea. I am sure their personalities are gestalting. I observed SCP-405-1 tapping the desk in a room yesterday in a manner consistent with playing the piano, but only SCP-405-1 has any musical talent. Worse, SCP-405-1 reported finding himself performing an action unconsciously and wished to know if I recognized it. SCP-405-1 was unconsciously field-stripping an imaginary. None of them have military backgrounds. They picked that up from us. If you get any more survivors, don't send them here. Dr. All interviews with SCP-405 victims, or SCP-405-1, are to be recorded in Interview Log 405. Interview Number 405-14-1. Interviewed. Agent B, diagnosed with terminal. Agent has volunteered to act as test subject. Interviewer, Dr. Forward. First in a series of logs over the stages of an SCP-405 infection. Use of an agent likely to ensure information is delivered as required. Primary stage. Begin log. Doctor, and how are we feeling today? Agent B, really, Doc? I thought these were meant to be as formal as possible. Anyway, I still feel fine, apart from the nausea from coming off the drugs. Doctor, any strange sensations? Audio hallucinations? Agent B, no, nothing. Doctor. Okay, moving on. Agent B. Hang on. You. Yes, you, the D in the corner. Will you stop humming? It's really distracting. Doctor. D isn't humming. Agent B. Really? I could have sworn. Oh, f**k. Already? End interview segment. Interview number 405145. Interviewed. Agent B. Interviewer. Doctor. Forward. Initial stage. Begin log. Agent B. No, I am not going to flip out this time. Jeez. Doctor. I haven't said anything yet. Agent B. Sorry. I can't tell the difference. Well, not always. Doctor. Explain. Agent B. Well, I just heard you say explain twice, right? Only one. One, I reckon, is how you... Fuck, sorry. Heard someone. One was how I reckon you must think you sound. Less nasally than your real voice. Doctor. Interesting. Agent B. Sorry, I didn't mean... Did you say that or just think it? I think it gets worse the longer I spend with a guy. End interview segment. Interview number 405-1421. Interviewed. Agent B. Interviewer. Dr. Original interviewer is providing advice via text feed. Forward. Escalation stage. Begin log. Agent B. I feel terrible. I haven't slept in 4 days, and I wish I had never volunteered for this damn experiment. Doctor. I hadn't. Agent B. I know you f***ing hadn't. I can hear you. I can hear those two brain donors. I can hear even though he's on the other side of the text feed. I can hear every damn person in this damn base. Doctor. Calm down. Agent B. You did not just tell me to calm down. How dare you tell me to calm down? I swear, if one more person tells me, or even thinks at me, to be calm, I will wring their f***ing necks. Some of the sick, sick things you guys think. I never knew I worked with such perverts. You know, the guy running this place, he every day. Why am I meatball salad today? This isn't my... Shut up! Shut up! Doctor, we need to discuss your symptoms. Agent B, can I have a pen and paper? I need to write this down. I can't think straight to talk. Pen and paper provided for Agent B. Agent B inserts pen a full inches into his ear. Interview terminated. End interview segment. Interview number 405-1429. Interviewed. Agent B. Restrained. Interviewer. Dr. Forward. Late plateau stage. Begin log. Agent B. Get out. Get the hell out. Go away. All of you go away. Dance. Do the maniac dance. Damn whore had it coming to her. How? Shut up. Shut up. Says here that his real name is 1234. 1234. 1234. It's all a cry for help, you know. One day, the world... How do you get it to the lock again? Elizabeth, I miss you, but not that... My head! Get out of my head! End log. Closing statement. The progression of symptoms here is clear. Agent B held out longer than most, but was driven to suicide 22 days after exposure. Agent B managed to pull over his restraint chair and... Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-404, Memories Lost, Memories Found, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.